नमस्ते जेवीन, मैं सर कृतिका शर्मा है फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फूड एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटनरी साइंसेज। सो द सब्जेक्ट वी बी टॉकिंग अबाउट टुडे इज द फूड प्रोसेस टेक्नोलॉजी एंड द टॉपिक व्हिच विल बी कवरिंग इज हर्डल टेक्नोलॉजी। राइट, सो हर्डल टेक्नोलॉजी, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय हर्डल टेक्नोलॉजी? वी विल फर्स्ट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द इंट्रोडक्शन। सो हर्डल टेक्नोलॉजी इज द कंबाइंड यूज ऑफ सेवरल प्रिजर्वेशन मेथड्स टू मेक अ प्रोडक्ट शेल्फ स्टेबल टू इम्प्रूव द quality and to provide additional safety. It is also known as combined method technology. Leister in 1976 introduced the term hurdle effect. Now, what is basically is the need for hurdle technology? Now, consumers are demanding for fresh, natural and minimally processed food products. Now, ongoing trend has been out to eat out and to consume ready to eat food products. New ecology roots for microbial growth have emerged. So, what are the basic principles of hurdle technology? Now, the different preservative factors or hurdles disturb the homeostasis of microorganisms. The microorganism should not be able to jump over all the hurdles present in the food product. Now, preservative factors prevent microorganisms from multiplying and causing them to remain inactive or even die. The hurdle concept illustrates that complex interactions of temperature, water activity, pH are significant to the microbial stability. So, we'll again discuss about the introduction part of the hurdle technology, that it is basically a combined use of several preservation methods to make a product shelf stable to improve the quality and to provide the additional safety. So the consumers are demanding for fresh, natural and minimally processed food products. The ongoing trend has been to eat out and to consume ready-to-eat food products. New ecological roots for microbial growth have emerged. So, to preservative factors of hurdles distribute the homeostasis of microorganisms. The microorganisms should not be able to jump over all the hurdles present in the food product. The preservative factors prevent the microorganisms from multiplying and causing them to remain inactive or even die. The hurdle concept illustrates that complex interactions of temperature, water activity, pH are significant for the microbial stability. So let's talk about the potential hurdles in the food preservation. So first talking about the high temperature. That is first classification among the high temperatures, the pasteurization. So the heat treatment, that is 63 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes or 100 degrees Celsius for 12 seconds, that is high product quality. It destroys the vegetative pathogens, that is disease-causing microorganisms, and it reduces the total microbial load. It increases the shelf life, right? It does not destroy the pores. That is a dormant stage of some bacteria. It usually combines with other hurdles, that is refrigeration. Next, talking about sterilization. So sterilization is the complete destruction of microorganisms. Severe heat treatment, that is equivalent to 121 degrees Celsius, it destroys the spores. It gives shelf-stable product. Some nutrient, quality destruction, flavor, etc. Now, blanching is a kind of pasteurization generally applied to fruits and vegetables. It is primarily applied to inactivate natural enzymes. It is commonly practiced when food is to be frozen. Now, depending upon its severity, it also destroys the microorganisms. The effect of heat on aerobic and anaerobic mesophilic bacteria, yeasts and molds. Now let us study what effect the aerobic and anaerobic bacteria has on heat. So the vegetative cells as well as viruses are destroyed at a temperature of 60 degrees Celsius to 80 degrees Celsius. Higher temperature may be needed for killing of thermophilic microorganisms. Vegetative cells are killed in 10 minutes at 100 degrees Celsius and many spores in 30 minutes at 100 degrees Celsius. Now, potential hurdles in food preservation. The next classification is of low temperature. The first among low temperature is refrigeration. Ideally, 0 degree to 4 degrees Celsius is the refrigeration temperature for most foods. Short-term preservation can be long for days to weeks. High production quality like fresh, minimally processed foods wise slows down microbial growth, respiration, enzyme chemical reactions. Some pathogens can grow, that is Clostridium botulinum, Escherichia coli, and Listeria. Now, freezing. Generally, the temperature range between freezing is minus 18 degrees Celsius to minus 30 degrees Celsius. The quality depends on the product, time, and temperature. The long-term preservation is from months to years. It stops microbial growth and respiration. It slows down chemical reaction, and it must have good packaging. Now, talking about the potential hurdles in food preservation, the potential hurdles in food preservation are reduced water activity, that is AW. AW is the symbol of water activity, is the water availability. Now, water is required for microbial growth and enzyme and chemical reactions. The pathogenic microorganisms cannot grow at water activity less than 0.86. Yeast and mold cannot grow at water activity less than 0.62. Now, free water can be removed by concentration, dehydration, and freeze drying. In general, the lower the water activity, the longer the storage life. So, there are some recommended substances to reduce the water activity, such as glucose, fructose, sodium chloride, and potassium chloride. Now, next under the classification of potential hurdles in food preservation is increased acidity, that is lowered pH. Now, acidity slows down the growth of spoilage organisms and pathogens. The pathogens won't grow, spores won't germinate at pH less than 4.5. Above 4.5 must sterilize for shelf stability. Below 4.5, we can pasteurize the product. Now, I repeat, increased acidity, that is lowered pH. So, acidity slows down the growth of spoilage organisms and pathogens. Now, pathogens won't grow if spores won't germinate at pH less than 4.5, that is fluorescence or crust. Above pH 4.5, it must sterilize for shelf stability. And below pH 4.5, we can pasteurize the food. Now, recommended substances to reduce the pH are below, that is organic acid, citric acid, malic acid, tartaric acid, benzoic acid, lactic and propionic acid. Also, there are some inorganic acids, and we can also increase the acidity in foods by fermentation of the byproducts. Now, potential hurdles in food preservation, the category is controlling the oxygen. Now, low oxygen inhibits the growth of many spiral organisms. But anaerobic conditions require some pathogens. Preservatives inhibit the bacteria, yeast, and mold. They're used at lower level for specific applications. Example, benzoate, propionate. Benzoates are used for soft drinks and propionates are used for baked goods. Nitrites are used for meats, sulfites for wine, ascorbates for juices. The potential chemical preservatives are sulfur dioxide and sulfites, nitrites and nitrates, sorbates, propionates, sodium benzoates. The potential hurdles in food preservation are the competitive microorganisms, that is good bacteria, inhibits the bad or the spoiler pathogens. इट मे एक्ट बाय क्राउडिंग आउट और प्रोड्यूसिंग एसिड और प्रोड्यूसिंग एंटीबायोटिक्स दैट इज बैक्टीरियोसिस और सच एज लैक्टिक एसिड बैक्टीरिया इन सॉरक्रॉट और योगर्ट. The sequence of hurdles ensures stability to each stage. All hurdles decline with time except water activity. Nitrite inhibits the growth of pathogens. The growth of other bacteria depletes oxygen. Low oxygen favors acid producing competitive flora. Acid decreases pH. Water activity hurdle gradually increases due to drying. Pasteurized processed cheese spreads. These products have pH less than 4.5 and water activity greater than 4.5. Should have to comply with the low acid canned foods that is commercial sterilization. However, for quality reasons, these products cannot be given a sterilization process. Instead, the spreads are stabilized by moderate levels of salt, decreased pH and moisture. So let's talk in brief about the significance of the hurdle technology. It improves the process quality, product quality, and microbial safety. It saves money, energy, and several other resources. The food remains stable and safe, high in sensory and nutritive value due to the gentle process applied. It doesn't affect the integrity of food pieces. It is applicable in both large and small industries. The manufacture of new product according to the need of processors and consumers. So, to brief about the hurdle technology, it is basically a combination of several preservation methods to make a product shelf stable, to improve the quality and to provide additional safety. It is also known as the combined method technology. Leisner in 1976 introduced the term hurdle effect. Now the consumers are demanding for fresh, natural and minimally processed food products. The ongoing trend has been to eat out and to consume ready-to-eat foods. New ecological routes for microbial growth have emerged, and that is how the need for hurdle technology is into existence. The basic principles of hurdle technology are the preservative factors or hurdles disturb the homeostasis of microorganisms. The microorganisms should not be able to jump over all the hurdles present in the food product. Preservative factors prevent microorganisms from multiplying and causing them to remain inactive or even die. The hurdle concept illustrates that complex interactions of temperature, water activity, pH are significant to the microbial stability. So, talking about the potential hurdles in food preservation, we have high temperature, low temperature, and water activity, then overpopulating the good bacteria. So, basically, in high temperature, we have pasteurization, sterilization, and blanching. So, mild heat treatment and high product quality destroys vegetative pathogens, reduces total microbial load, increases the shelf life, does not destroy, dispose, and usually combined with the hurdles, that is refrigeration. Sterilization means the complete destruction of microorganisms. Severe heat treatment, that is equivalent to several minutes at 121 degrees Celsius. It destroys the spores and gives shelf stable products, some nutrient quality destruction, that is flavor, texture. Blanching is a kind of pasteurization generally applied to fruits and vegetables. It is primarily applied to inactivate the natural enzymes. Commonly practiced when food is to be frozen, it depends on the severity, also destroys the microorganisms. So the effect of heat on aerobic and anaerobic bacteria and super bacteria of yeast molds. So that is all for this session. We'll be continuing with the food process technology in the next session. Thank you.